गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द वर्किंग ऑफ EGR वॉल्व और EGR सिस्टम। ओके, व्हाट इज EGR सिस्टम? EGR स्टैंड्स फॉर एग्जॉस्ट गैस रिसर्कुलेशन सिस्टम। ओके, सो व्हाट हैपन, व्हाई दिस EGR सिस्टम इज गोइंग टू इंस्टॉल? बिकॉज इट रिड्यूसेस द पोल्यूशन। ओके, दैट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ द EGR सिस्टम, एग्जॉस्ट गैस रिसर्कुलेशन सिस्टम। Now what happened in the IC engine? IC engine has a in a 4-stroke IC engine there are 4 strokes, that is suction, compression, power and exhaust. Okay, so during the power stroke what happened, the when the piston from BDC to is compressed to TDC, or it, when the piston moves to BDC to TDC, it compressed air, and that compressed air what happened, fuel is injected. Okay, in CI engine when the fuel is injected, it burns, and it when the fuel burns, it produces a power, and okay, and after that power stroke, all the exhaust gases which burns are expelled out in the exhaust stroke. Okay, so in the exhaust stroke what happened, exhaust stroke, the gases which are burned contain the carbon monoxide, CO, hydrocarbon, and NOx. Okay, so this carbon monoxide and hydrocarbons are well controlled by introducing multi-point fuel injections or advanced fuel injection system, so that the complete combustion of fuel takes place. Okay, but what happened to nitrox oxide, NOx? This NOx formation, our aim is to reduce this NOx formation, nitrox oxide formation. Okay, now what happened when the during the suction stroke, when the air is sucked inside the combustion chamber, the air contains the oxygen molecule and nitrogen molecule. Okay, nitrogen molecules are more, as the percentage of nitrogen on the atmosphere is about 71%, so there is a large amount of nitrogen present in the combustion chamber as well as oxygen molecules. And when the fuel is injected into this oxygen and nitrogen molecule, okay, what happened, the oxygen molecules combined with the fuel molecules. Okay, and when this during the combustion, this oxygen supports the combustion of this fuel molecule. Okay, oxygen reacts with this fuel molecule and it forms a combustion. Okay, and when this oxygen molecules combines with the fuel molecules, the fuel molecule will burn, and when this fuel molecule burns, it will increase the temperature of the combustion chamber to what we'll say about 2500 degrees Celsius, near about 2000, above the 2000 degrees Celsius. Okay, that means the combustion temperature of the combustion chamber is very very high. Okay, now in that case what happened, during the deceleration of the engine, that is when we decelerate the engine, what happened, the amount of the fuel in the entering in the combustion chamber is reduced. Okay, that means the oxygen fuel molecules entering into the combustion chamber are reduced. Okay, in that case what happened, less amount of fuel molecules and oxygen molecules are combined, and less power is produced during the deceleration. Okay, and some of the oxygen molecules are still left into the combustion chamber. Okay, now in the combustion chamber, these oxygen molecules as well as these nitrogen molecules, okay, in the presence of very high temperature, that is about 2000 degrees Celsius, in that high temperature these two molecules combine with each other, there is nitrogen and oxygen. Okay, in presence of very high temperature, these two molecules combine to form nitrox oxide. Okay, that means the absence of fuel molecule and the presence of nitrogen and oxygen at with very high temperature is responsible to produce the nitrox oxide. Okay, now our aim is to restrict the formation of nitrox oxide into the combustion chamber. So what we will do, वी कांट रिस्ट्रिक्ट द परसेंटेज ऑफ ऑक्सीजन मॉलिक्यूल्स प्रेजेंट एंटरिंग इन टू द कम्बशन चैम्बर. ओके, ऑल्सो वी कांट रिस्ट्रिक्ट द अमाउंट ऑफ नाइट्रोजन मॉलिक्यूल प्रेजेंट इन द कम्बशन चैम्बर. इट इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट. ओके, सो इफ यू रिस्ट्रिक्ट द नाइट्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन मॉलिक्यूल्स एंटरिंग इन टू द कम्बशन चैम्बर, दैट मीन्स इफ वी रिस्ट्रिक्ट द अमाउंट ऑफ इनकमिंग एयर इन टू द कम्बशन चैम्बर, देन वॉट हैपन, द वॉल्यूमेट्रिक एफिशियंसी ऑफ द इंजिन will reduced. Okay, that will engine will not produce the sufficient amount of power as less amount of air is introduced into the combustion chamber. Okay, so what we will do, so the only thing we have to do is to reduce this temperature 2000 degrees Celsius. Okay, that means we have to reduce the temperature. Now how to reduce this temperature? So for the reduction of this temperature, we have to divert these burn gases. Okay, then these are the burn gases. We have to divert the burn gases into the intake manifold as shown like this. Okay, now this is the exhaust manifold in which some of the gas is diverted into this, and it is diverted into the intake manifold like this, from EGR valve, exhaust gas recirculation valve. Okay, so what happened if we divert this exhaust gases into the intake manifold? If you divert these exhaust gases into the intake manifold, now we all know that these exhaust gases are burned gases. Okay, so as these gases are burned gases, it will, and if we divert these burned gases into the combustion chamber, okay, so when these burned gases will enter into the combustion chamber, it will not take part into the combustion. Okay, it will act as a fire extinguisher. It will act as a ice cubes or fire extinguisher. Okay, so as it is, it doesn't take part in the combustion, okay, so as it doesn't take part in combustion, and so on, as it is acts as a fire extinguisher, the overall temperature of the combustion chamber during the operation will be dropped less than 1600 degrees Celsius, because there is a presence of the inert gas into the combustion chamber. Okay, and as the temperature falls below 1600 degrees Celsius, then in that case there is no formation of, that is, there is no combination of nitrogen and oxygen, because the temperature of the combustion chamber is now less than 1600 degrees Celsius. Okay, there is no combination or no formation of nitrous oxide, and combustion chamber is free of NOx, which is very harmful. Okay, now the amount of the burned gases enter into the combustion chamber depending upon this EGR valve. Okay, now this EGR valve is responsible to introduce these burned gases into the combustion chamber as shown in this figure. Okay, that is, the first the burned gases will go to the intake of the EGR, and then it is diverted into the combustion chamber. Now why this EGR valve is provided in this particular circuit? Okay, that is, this EGR valve restricts the supply of the inert gases during the operation of this EGR system. Okay, and this EGR valve is controlled by this EGR control solenoid, and this solenoid is controlled by engine computer. Okay, now why this EGR valve is given? Now the thing is that during the idling of this engine, that is during the idling or at a very low RPM of the engine, and what happened, this EGR valve shuts down that completely. Okay, that is, it doesn't allow any recirculating exhaust gas to enter into the combustion chamber. Okay, now why it is so, why it doesn't allow the exhaust gas to recirculate during the idling? So the thing is that during the idling, what happened, there is overall less vacuum pressure produced by the engine. Okay, and so as there is a less vacuum pressure, less amount of air is sucked into the combustion chamber. Okay, and at the idling there is also the high rotational inertia of the engine. Okay, so to tackle this high rotational inertia and low vacuum pressure, we need a more amount of oxygen and a little bit more amount of fuel. The oxygen requirement is more at idling to form a strong combustion at idling to increase the cycle pressure to overcome the rotational inertia of the engine. Okay, so for that purpose, EGR valve completely shuts down during the idling, so that the exhaust gas will not mix into the combustion chamber while idling, and it will not dilute the charge coming during the idling. Okay, so in that case this will be completely closed. And during the sudden power requirement of the engine, if you want a sudden power requirement, and if we suddenly increase the accelerator of the engine, then in that case what happened, this EGR valve is again completely closed. Okay, now during the sudden acceleration what happened, a fuel is suddenly injected into the combustion chamber. Okay, and when the fuel is suddenly injected into the combustion chamber, the combustion chamber should already be filled with the more amount of oxygen. Okay, now in this particular case, when we suddenly press the accelerator of the vehicle and there is a less amount of oxygen, then what happened, the fuel molecules will not combine with oxygen and doesn't produces the power required during the sudden acceleration, because if we allow the exhaust gas, burnt exhaust gas, during the acceleration what happened, this burnt exhaust gas will act as a barrier, or it will not take part in combustion. So as it they doesn't take part in combustion, so in that particular case the overall power of the engine will reduce. Okay, so during the sudden power requirement also, this EGR valve shuts the exhaust gas, recirculation gas, to enter into the combustion chamber, so that more and more amount of oxygen will present into the combustion chamber, and hence the fuel is injected, it will suddenly form a power, so that there is a quick response of the engine for the sudden power increase. Okay, so this control of the EGR valve, that is during the idling it should be closed, and during the sudden power requirement this should also be closed, and during the partial load, that is during the cruising of the engine, this should be open. So these three cases are identified by this EGR control, EGR temperature sensor, as well as this temperature sensor is given to the engine computer system, is attached to the engine computer system. Okay, as well as this engine computer system, ECM also monitors the engine load. It also monitor the engine load, RPM of engine, okay, throttle position, and etc. Okay, all these parameters are collected by these sensors, load sensor, RPM sensor, TP sensor, etc., and given to the engine computer. Okay, so according to this parameter collected by these various sensor, engine computer decides when and where to activate the EGR valve. Okay, so if the RPM of the engine is very low, then the RPM sensor will sense the low RPM, and ECM will close the EGR valve. Okay, if the load is very high, okay, and TP throttle position sensor is at the open side, then what happens, suddenly open side, then what happened, again the ECM will shuts the EGR control valve, so that exhaust gas will not recirculate into the combustion chamber. So all these parameters are controlled by the engine computer. Okay, and according to this parameter the signals are given to the EGR valve, EGR control solenoid, and then to the EGR valve. Okay, so that engine will run with the optimum power and less reduction of nitrous oxide. Okay, so this is how the EGR control system works. Okay, thank you.